I am here in Osswald, NYC with Sara Carner.
Hello, good evening. How are you?
I'm excellent. I'm so glad to be at this event. I've always been a fan of your brand.
Thank you.
And it was great. We met at an Elements event a couple of years ago.
Exactly. It was a pleasure. Very nice to meet you.
It was great. I want to talk to you about your brand because your brand is very unique. Sara Carner,
yes.
Carner Barcelona. You live in Spain?
Yes, I live in Spain. In fact, this is our fifth anniversary, so we've been around 5 years this year.
That's great.
Yeah, it's a nice. So we are kind of celebrating this together with a new product we are launching, and it's great to have you here.
No, what's interesting about your brand is that you have a family of leather makers.
Artisans, exactly.
Artisans.
Yes.
Horses and...
Well, yes. I mean, my great-grandfather started the business, the leather business. They started manufacturing shoe soles, and with the years, it evolved into more luxurious, big, you know, pieces of leather, which they sell to the fashion houses. So I grew up within this environment of leathers, smoke, because they used to smoke a lot in the past.
Okay. So the tobacco smells,
yeah,
and the wood smells.
Yeah, the barrels get the tan leather,
yeah, sure,
made out of wood. So all this is it's very familiar smells for me.
How did it turn into a passion for a fragrance?
Well, it has nothing to do, in fact, you
no.
know, because leathers
so
and...
How did you spin off?
I always had a passion for perfumes.
Okay.
And since I was little, I knew I love it. And life, you know, studies, professional experiences brought me into this point.
Okay.
In which I had the chance to start my own project, my own collection, and
yeah,
I didn't hesitate. I jumped in it and...
Is your family still doing the leather?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. So you're still involved in it and your family's still in it?
I'm not involved, my family.
My
father, my cousin,
okay.
yes.
And Carner Barcelona as a fragrance company has really taken off. I mean, you are in the Middle East, you're all over, right?
We started with two perfumes. We have five perfumes now. We started in a small boutique in Barcelona. We have more than 200 points of sale all over the world, in Europe and in the Middle East, in America.
Yeah.
So can't complain. It's been a nice trip so far,
yeah,
and for many years to come, I hope.
Well, let's talk about a couple of the scents briefly. We know my favorite is D600.
I know.
That's been one of my signature scents for a very long time. It's comfortable. It's iris. I love iris. It's very unisex, but I also feel it warms up and it really works.
It develops a lot into the skin. It's
with the wearer, with the person who's wearing it. So
absolutely, it's a very unique perfume.
What was and again? I mean, we're doing not too long of an interview, but what's the passion behind what created D600 for you? That was one of the first ones, right?
Absolutely.
TARDIS, so, and it was that.
D600 is a tribute to my hometown, to Barcelona. It starts with these spicy notes and citric notes, just like the air of La Boqueria and La Ramblas. When you get, you know, there's the market, and you get all this spiciness and this citric notes. And then I wanted the perfume to become something sophisticated, something very nighty, you know. Just like Barcelona, very cosmopolitan and modern. So we use this type of, ingredients, just like you said, iris, also vetiver. There's wood also inside.
Yeah.
It's a very sophisticated and evolving perfume that reminds me a lot about Barcelona. It's very modern. It's very cosmopolitan.
It is.
That's what we were looking for in this perfume.
I agree. Along with D600, we also have TARDIS, which was one of the second one?
Yeah, I mean, we launched both of them together, TARDIS and D600.
You did, yeah. Okay.
So, I mean,
this is heliotrope, Angelica, right? What else?
Exactly. This one has almonds. At the beginning, it has almonds, geranium, it has celery, it has plum, it has a tonka bean.
Yeah.
So, heliotropy as well, musk. It's powdery and it's more warm than maybe the 600.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The next one that came out was Cures.
Cures, exactly. Cures. Which you know, it's the one that it's all about my family heritage, the leather factory, the small, the wood of the barrels. the leathers.
A little bit more masculine of the other scents.
Yeah, maybe this one is the more masculine. Almost. Although I have to say that it's, I mean, it's very successful among women also. Yeah. They like it also.
Yeah. Yeah.
We like it, every day. We like more strong perfumes.
That's true. Women. Yeah. Rima.
Rima 11 is it's
and this
a
is fairly new. This came out last year.
Yes, this came, yeah.
Right.
This one, it's inspired in a poem of Becker, which is a poet of the 19th century. It's a romantic poet that talks about this untouchable woman, this the sensuality behind, which is not the woman that is not conquerable. So it has these sweet notes, these sensual notes, nutmeg, coriander, cinnamon.
Geared a little bit more feminine.
More feminine, absolutely.
But fairly unisex. I mean, it has a clean...
It's unisex, but it's more... you know, we said queer is masculine. This
so
would
this
be
would lean feminine.
This is more towards feminine.
And the most recent one
that came out
is El Born.
This June,
tell us
yeah.
about El... What is it?
El Born. This El came Born. Out last June.
Last June.
And this perfume, it's inspired in the neighborhood of El Born, which is a very interesting and unique neighborhood of Barcelona. There are plenty of coffee shops, liquor stores, vintage stores, museums. It's like the medieval area of Barcelona.
Okay.
So I was inspired by all that environment. I wanted to capture...
There's a lot of character in this fragrance. Yes. There's a lot of licorice. And licorice is a very, anise is a very interesting note to use and to work with.
It's very licorice and it develops a lot also into the skin.
I get some patchouli.
There's patchouli.
Okay.
And it gets honey, angelica.
Interesting notes.
Yes.
I mean, you combine things that...
Absolutely.
One thing about all of your fragrances, this is very interesting. They're all very unique. They don't smell like other
and
brands.
It turns out very woody, in fact. It starts with this licorice accent, but then it's very, very woody.
It's very woody, and the honey
and
stays.
Very warm, absolutely.
That's what keeps it warm. The
exactly.
sweetness, it's like a natural sweetness where that honey is just natural. It's
and
not
you,
an,
after 2 or 3 hours, you don't feel that much the liquor on it.
Yep.
You feel more the warmth than the wood of the
I wore all day today. It smells fantastic.
Great,
thank you. Great one. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
What else can you tell us? You may be going bigger places.
Well,
you may
we are opening
up the market, we should say. So
we keep
on the lookout without giving away too many things.
The brand is we started in America 2 years ago, so 2.5 years ago, and it's been a steady growth.
Yep.
But now we want to maybe jump into the next level
and let more people out
and
there
kind
of get a chance.
I will try
right?
to exactly. Yeah. I will try also to get myself into the process of building the brand in the U.S.
Good.
So I'll be back and forth, Barcelona, New York,
awesome.
Spain, great. America. This is a fantastic market, and it's the place to be, you know?
Yeah.
So we'll see.
So that means keep your eye out, and, is there any other fragrances that are going to be coming soon that you can give us sneak peeks?
Yes, we are developing a new perfume, but for next year, maybe spring or summer, we'll see.
Okay.
We want to grow the line a little bit more.
Okay.
And still a small five perfumes.
Yeah.
We want to give the customer the chance to select from
wide range.
A wider range.
Any tips of what notes may be featured?
I will let you know. It's about, it's roses and paper.
Okay. Okay.
Roses and paper.
Okay.
Ink. Paper.
Ink and paper. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And one thing that I love about the brand is that you have never discontinued anything, and you don't have any plans to.
No,
you want
absolutely.
This to be a family company that grows.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, all perfumes are, of course, they are best. They're
best sellers, and maybe not.
Yeah, exactly. But, I love all of them. They are my little kids, my little babies. And, I mean, also they all sell. It's not that there are perfumes that don't sell.
Right.
I mean, So I don't have plans of discontinuing, of course.
And they've all touched people in their own way, and you and
absolutely.
Your
and it's so nice to get comments online and to get comments from bloggers or from journalists or from just clients that send you their feedback and their opinion. And it's so rewarding when someone tells you, "This is the perfume of my life," or "I wore this in my wedding."
In my wedding, and then it's special too.
Exactly, so special, and it's something also very personal for me. All the perfumes.
Yeah. Last question. What do you pick up and put on most of the time?
D600.
D600.
Yeah.
It's a winner.
It's true. It's my favorite. I mean, I love all of them, yeah. But my daily perfume is the 600. That's it. Yeah.
Guys, Sara Carner. Carner Barcelona, check out the scents. Come here to Osswald's, check them out. Go online, and that's
it. Thank you.
I'll see you
soon. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.